Hi everyone, I hope you're all going well. I wanted to make a quick video today that's kind of Life is Strange related, but it is very exciting and it does relate to Dontnod Entertainment, the developers behind Life is Strange. Just a short time ago, they released a lot of details behind a new game they've been working on with Bandai Namco. Twin Mirror, a narrative-driven psychological thriller set in the small town of Basswood, West Virginia, coming in 2019 to PS4, Xbox One, and PC. They released a short trailer as well as a brief description of the game and its story that I want to cover today. Now, don't worry, I'm still a Life is Strange channel, that won't change anytime soon. I will have another video on Captain Spirit, the other game leading up to the next Life is Strange, that will cover some interesting news that we've learned about it. In the meantime, I've been interested to see what else Dontnod has been up to alongside Life is Strange and Vampyr. So, with that out of the way, let's talk about Twin Mirror. The first two things I want to touch on is the story and the setting. Twin Mirror follows the tale of Sam, a 33-year-old man who has returned to his hometown of Basswood, West Virginia to attend the funeral of his best friend. However, one morning he wakes up in his hotel room with no memory of the night before and finds his shirt which is covered in blood. The story then follows Sam investigating what happened the night before and uncovering the truth. In the game's description on the Bandai Namco website, Sam is described as understandably depressed and bitter. He feels completely out of place. He's recently been through a breakup that he's trying to overcome, and is described as a tormented hero who must walk a tightrope between the harsh realities of the film noir-esque Basswood, West Virginia, and his own personal struggle. Oscar Gilbert, the CEO of Dontnod, describes the game as a stunning emotional journey heavily rooted in the concept of duality, redemption, and self-acceptance. So right away, Twin Mirror appears very narrative-driven and has a large focus on its main character, Sam. The focus of Twin Mirror's gameplay seems to revolve around two things very similar to Life is Strange: investigation and choices. On the PlayStation blog's announcement for the game, it states, "Sam finds himself dejected and downtrodden as he interacts with former friends in his hometown," interacts being the important word there. It's now up to Sam to recall his memories and search for disparate clues in Basswood to find the truth in this mysterious investigation. Then there's a short paragraph summing up the entire game. Twin Mirror is a psychological thriller wrapped around an investigation where your memories, choices, and relationships will determine Sam's complicated fate, as he comes to terms with heartbreak, homecoming, and the perpetual struggle of adulthood. Boy, do I feel you on that one, Sam. From this description, and me being a huge Life is Strange fan, and me loving any kinds of media with a little mystery in them, I'm pretty much 100% on board with Twin Mirror. This sounds incredibly intriguing and mysterious, reminds me a lot of Alan Wake from back in the day, kind of feels tropish with the whole main protagonist has amnesia thing, but the rest of it sounds pretty solid. There's also no denying that there's a lot of similarities between this and Life is Strange. Main protagonist is returning to their hometown, feels isolated in their environment, reconnecting with their old friends, middle, and there's also a mystery to investigate pulling the story forward. Looking back at the Bandai Namco website quickly, your choices and values decide Sam's place in life as you shape his relationships with the Basswood inhabitants. Seems very reminiscent of the choices you would make, both big and in dialogue, in Life is Strange that would determine your relationship with a number of different characters in Arcadia Bay. I'm not saying these similarities are a bad thing, I'm kind of glad they're sticking to what works, and I think there's definitely enough here with this concept to differentiate it from Life is Strange, but the similarities are there. There are a few things though that set Twin Mirror apart from Life is Strange, like this memory recall that keeps getting referenced everywhere. Oscar gives a little more detail and says, "Twin Mirror offers the ability to dive into Sam's painful memories to personally and uniquely shape the investigation through a series of gut-wrenching, impactful choices." This, combined with some of the shots in the trailer of Sam hugging this woman in this nightmare-esque sequence, along with whatever the fuck is going on here, seems to indicate that Sam's memories will have a major part to play in the gameplay alongside the story, maybe allowing us to interactively explore Sam's man's memory, and maybe even memories that go further back than the night before. You could say that this is very similar to Max jumping back in time through photos and exploring a small section of her past. However, since Max could influence the past with time travel stuff and Sam is simply just trying to remember his past, I'd say it sets the two games apart that way. The text throughout the trailer, "Your mind is the one place to find the truth," I guess would further reinforce that there's no real supernatural sci-fi stuff going on, and all of this is just in Sam's head, a way for us to interactively explore Sam's memory. So to recap, Twin Mirror is a narrative-driven, psychological thriller following the story of Sam, an investigative journalist in his hometown of Basswood, West Virginia, with a heavy focus on character and mystery, with gameplay revolving around investigation, interacting with the townspeople, and recalling memories from Sam's past. That's about everything we know so far, which leaves behind a whole bunch of questions regarding what we don't know, like, will this game be episodic? Everywhere I looked, I couldn't find any clarification as to whether the release in 2019 would be for episode 1 or a full game. I went back and looked at the first trailer ever released for Life is Strange, and there is an indication at the end of the trailer that Life is Strange would be a 5-part series launching in 2015, which by that logic, looking at this trailer, I guess indicates that it won't be a 5-part series and will be a full game? Which is kind of strange to me. I figured a game surrounding a mystery would be perfect for an episodic format, keeping us on the edge of our seats at the end of every episode for what happens next. I'll wait for further clarification in the future on that one. The second question I have is, what is up with this scene? It looks like Sam is fighting some ghostly figure in a bar that's situated in this dream world or memory world type thing. It could be one of his memories that we can interact with. Sam can remember fighting someone in a bar but can't remember who he was fighting, so maybe a part of this sequence before or after is trying to figure out who he was fighting. I originally thought this may have been a combat sequence and maybe there was a little bit more to the gameplay with Twin Mirror, but it's hard to really say at this point. The third question I have is with the graphics. In the screenshots released with the announcement on the PlayStation blog, it doesn't look too bad. It's not hand-painted Life is Strange aesthetics, but it does look pretty nice. However, in the trailer, the graphics are questionable at times. It doesn't look so great in a lot of areas. The game is still in development and still has a long way to go until 2019, so I think it's fair to assume that this is just a very early look at the game and the graphics will improve. Hopefully. And the last question I have is, what does this game coming out in 2019 mean for Life is Strange Season 2? Does it mean that it could potentially come out this year? Or if Twin Mirror releases late next year, then it could still come out in early 2019? Well, a little while ago, it was announced that Dontnod Entertainment would be going public on the Euronext Growth Stock Exchange. Bunch of businessy stuff, they want to finance more of their games themselves so that they can take on more controlled financial risk while still securing funding from other publishers, which I am all for, the more control they have the better. But with that announcement also came this image of Dontnod's past and future projects, with the Life is Strange sequel and Twin Mirror both slated to be released between 2018 and 2020. With Twin Mirror expected to come out in 2019 and the fact that the Life is Strange image is just before the Twin Mirror image, I think it would still be a good bet that Life is Strange Season 2 would be coming later this year, maybe in September, who knows. It should also be noted, now that I've brought up this image, that Dontnod have a lot of projects planned for their future. Not only are they working on this game and Life is Strange Season 2, but they also have another game that they're working on alongside those, probably releasing in 2020, along with another two projects planned between 2020 and 2022. Life is Strange 3 Hype? There's some things about this I would like to talk about here, but I think I'll leave it for another day. So, that's Twin Mirror. What do you guys think of Dontnod's new game? Are you excited about it? Are you feeling a more darker, grittier game rather than a comfy one? Let me know all of your thoughts in the comments. Thank you all so much for watching, and I'll be back with a more in-depth look at the awesome adventures of Captain Spirit. Until then, have a great day.